Good morning students, I am Dr. Shruti. Today we will going to discuss about the bureaucratic management theories. Let's talk about it. So the bureaucratic theory, like similarly like F.W. Taylor and Henry Fayol, Max Weber was the person who propounded the theory of the bureaucratic management. He was a German lawyer, a politician, a historian, a political economist and the sociologist. Weber completed his doctoral dissertation on the contribution of the history of the medieval business organizations. Max Weber was the first administrative thinker to study the interrelationship between the state and society. As a scholar of the law, he understood the significance of the power, authority and the legitimacy. Now, what is Weber's theory of bureaucracy? We need to understand that Weber's bureaucracy is based upon the legal rational authority. The following was the following are the basic features of the of his theory of bureaucracy, which we will discuss later. But before that, Weber's bureaucracy is based on the legal rational authority. Now, a bureaucratic organization is based on the well-defined hierarchy. Hierarchy is based upon the authority. Division of labor. Now, there are certain features which I wanted to tell you about. The first one is hierarchy. So hierarchy means there should be certain levels. The authority should be based on the certain levels. Higher to the lower. Higher middle level managers and then lower level staff. Now, division of labor. Division of labor, yeah, division of work, functional specialization. Every employee in the organization has a well-defined power and the authority based upon the employee specialization and the expertise. So, the division of labor will be done on the basis of the expertise the employee is having. Now, next one is consistency. These all are features of the bureaucracy. Now, bureaucratic organization functions within the framework of the fixed rules and the regulations. So rules and regulate all the matters abstractly, right? I mean, I wanted to say that the consistency is required means no one is special. Everyone will be in the organization will treat it as the same way. The next one is qualification. The bureaucrats should be properly scientifically selected. This enables the efficiency of the bureaucracy. Now, the people should be selected in the organization on the basis of their qualifications. If the top level persons are have certain norms on in their qualifications, middle level managers or middle level staff is having certain other norms of qualifications, and the lower level staff is having certain other norms of qualifications. So that is very much important for the in the case of the bureaucracy. Such a bureaucratic organization specifies the duties and the responsibilities of the bureaucrats. Authority implies the responsibility. Every bureaucratic organization functions with the specific procedures laid down by the organization. This procedure is laid down by performing their functions. One of the unique features suggested by the Weber in the in impersonal approach of the employees in the organization. Every employee should function with impersonal approach while performing the duties. So this is what the bureaucratic management is, and this is what we talked about the bureaucratic theory. So students, this is all for the day. I hope you like this video. If you have any kind of query, please do let me know. I'll definitely try to sort your problems. Thank you so much, students. Have a great day.